certainly are on the way in the results. Kyle Brownsville is happening in Sydney, assisted by Adam Brown, who might not be his brother, or cousin, who knows, and Matthew Edwards, who may or may not be the right to Luke Edwards, which is not the same. Okay, fair enough. Got a few brothers going away in the fields as well. Feels like we're at the London Stadium. John Marine's on the ball. That plays out to Collett on the set on side, right starting the five. There's a good crotch in the centre, but running away back to Coleman. And it falls now for Luke Daly. He had a great game against the Tigers in the reverse pitch earlier in the season. Coleman, a month ago, weren't it? Rain sodden day at the Butcher's Arms. He's bringing the ball away on the far side. Flicks it down the channel, but it goes back to throwing some sides on halfway. We've run through the two teams for the Christmas Valley. Pete Crooks in goal behind, with James Burton making his return to the side, with Kyle Brown at the left back, Ross Daly Tyrone Gaines, Paddy Miller, captain, two centre halves now. In the books, Ross Daly, going up to Elliot Rocker, Luke Collett, and Big Cam Suckey, coming back into the side, with Don Marie leading the line. So 4-2-3-1, I should expect to be at times. On the bench, Paddy Foulkes, Max Lennon, Dominic Hale, Ben Deegan, and Carl Jones. For the Bloods, they went with Richard Bonnegan in next. He'll be very entertaining, I can assure you. Actually, come to this in the morning, so he's going to look for three balls, A little bit of space on the near side for Browner, he gets on his left leg. Swings across towards the far post, a little bit too deep. Oh, actually, he's kept him at the far stick there. I think it's dangerous. It's Rocker actually working deep, nodded away from the near post by Kaponu. In there goes Brownhill, nodding down in the eye, and eventually the Bloods smuggle it away off the head there of Gonzalez, but only as far as Miller. He puts it back into the channel, and that's going to go straight back to Richard Brownhill. But here he's scored by the time to start things off. Good opening 2 minutes. But we'll just carry on very quickly with the Bloods. Good ball back from Swabber, head forward, possibly a little bit of a risky back pass from over there. He's at left back, Shaquille Clark, he's at right back, they're performing in. We'll figure it out, we'll just try and figure out who's where. But it's either Smith or Ali. I think it's going to be Mo Ali at centre half, actually. Dylan Smith in this room, alongside Luke Bell, Callum Dancher, and up front, three prong attack. Second guy, Jay Green, captain, and Liam Caddick. On the bench, we've got John Smith, John Shaw, Levi Phillips, Sean Hillman, and Evan Moran.
People can see real good crowding in the world. Started putting tempers, they felt like going by and setting up a fortune in the end, and they started to build a temper, haven't they?
Certainly have, and there's a free kick right on the far side, looks good to take it, now at 40 yards of the touchline, right hugging the front. Little starts the penalty spot, Dave's up for it, Deegan misses it, shot comes in, delivered back into the centre by Rocker, can't quite get to the centre, comes on time, runs knocked away, comes back, he got his body in the way. And the second one, it was just kind of shanked away. And Tigers keep it on the far side. Good feet, good handsome there, as you'd expect there. And it's going to be throwing on the far side for Hyde. Best action. Good start this for Hyde. One of the great commends for the grip and to be better off one.
Ball the visitors, Browner lets that run past his chest and it's out for throwing on this near side.
We've got sandwiches down here as well, aren't
these? It's a who's who of non-league. A good work by Brannigan, always going to be fast off his line and in bright light. And he comes somewhere on the outside of his right boot, on the inside of his left. Plays it back to Browner on his left hand. Orange boot, kicks it into the area, looking for the run of Rocker. Does really well, take it down, shoots it!
Yes,
it is!
Brodman was scoring for Hyde United on 5 minutes.
Yes!
Number 7, Elliot
Rocker.
Bloodstone
Smith in that kind of midfield role gives it to Carly on the left hand side.
Offside
decision given now on the far side, it's Caddick. So you'd also wonder, 7 minutes gone in the game, it is 1-0 to the time. As I've watched my great to see Rocker get up the score sheet, you know. I mean, it didn't look like he had all the confidence in the world the other day, running into a bit of a wall and work back from left. A big attacker by the time. He runs off the end of the game, he was up there, but flag for offside, looks a little bit iffy that today, but never mind.
It was great to see. He's a great shot. Took the ball, passed the ball as well, and spun round, mounted his own shot really.
There's no such thing as overexcitement when your team scores. This is the thing with the Archers.
They're very doer, aren't they? You've got to get excited by it. It's a pack of
pants. Well, in fairness, you get quite giddy about that. Well, you might even buy a round.
Can I just say, you haven't got any to drink this year, 2018, this coming year?
Because you're so far away from the bar, there's no point in giving it. Anyway, draws in on the move, just inside the goal now. Good ball played there by Smith, out to the left flank. And it's a decent cross, I'm going to say decent. Oh, it's a decent crossing in the end. It's Killini on the end of it, but it'd already gone out of play by the time he reached it.
It was a little bit
it's Barber who can charge it from the full back door as well. We've got into the end of it. He's a really good run from the match. He's lively in the other game. Stopped by Bagshaw now, looking for Killini. A shot comes in from Caddick, decent effort too, but down to the right hand side there was Pete Crook and a very smart save.
It was a good effort in trust, but again, starting position, you probably arguably one of the best keepers out there. His position's really good, he made it look really comfortable in the end.
Well, in this division, you'd have to say there's only some something. Who's probably the best team. It was certainly out for me, and I really like Taylor Exchard, but I think probably just about changing. I'll wait, then again, we'll check to the door. Bomber gets in a little bit of a muddle as well. Bomber gets out of the middle of the line. Cleans up, but surrounded by high players. Manchester United are back to back and score back into his own area for the moment. Rock the ball into the middle, a bit wayward though, he really opened his legs first time we've seen him do that at the Euros, and it was a good run, but it cost him a little bit of so goal kick's taken very quickly by Bradley, he plays it out to Clark.
The way Jolson played, the way Jolson played plays into my hands, because I express my own. And again, a different kind of, he wasn't under any pressure, he was a good left of time.
Is that central? He'll bring an omnibus on the tip if it looks good. You know, he's great front to watch, but he did hit him for things to see. Yeah. Throwing safe in back, a little bit too much meat in that game. He's just seen it.
He's still a
you don't need to do anything spectacular, and that's what Yanni doesn't do. You know, that's a great ball. Pinsar is out to the left, but a little bit too much on that one, and it goes out on the far side of getting far, coming up from the fullback ball. It's going to be a throw into the side.
Jimmy Bennett, the reason that happens.
Well, it's actually the first game there you go, I thought was playing.
We have got to be playing.
Oh, great touch by Corrie. Gets across it towards the near post. Back there, we're late to the danger. Going to be a call for Tiger's first one in the game, but that touch done by Holloway, just going around over the team after you're looking straight in my eyes, longingly. But when you saw it,
yeah, it's a good one. By the car, the one that
Licker with the ball, goes deep with this one. Back paddling there, feeling for a handball against Gonzalez. It's nothing given, no one's going to be out of the throw into the Tigers. 25 yards up on the far side, good to take. But we're going to do things slightly differently today, by the way. We're going to do 15 minute stints in the crowd, so it's going to be coming on in a couple of minutes' time. And then we take 20 yard time and we'll see what happens. 1 minute to the Tigers, and 13 minutes gone in the game. It is in 6 minutes. Although, speaking of it, on the team sheet, wait, but I'm not even knowing, nobody could see me, a little number six. Was Tony being pathetic? Yeah. Anyway, throw in for the Tigers. Burke again, 20 yards. Throws it into the back there with Lockhart. Back to Burke. The ball, better ball into the middle this time. 50 P's really off the top of John Lewin's head. And he goes almost out of the ground that way. Three header, probably should have done better. Well, the point of time ball in this game, still 75 minutes or so to go. Is Pellini running after this one? Miller beats him two at the baseline. Back with the line, and it's claimed by Clark. Cuts in field now on his left foot, gives it to Backshot, spreads it Backshot again. He's with the number six, Dylan Smith. The one who had a decent game against the Tigers, but there's Daly on the far side for Blunt. Good tackle there by Bill. That's a toe on the end of that one, which is going to be for the visitors on the far side of that. Oh, really? Oh, thank you very much. I'm right for one shot, it's a player on my winning, I mean, I've seen it a few times, and generally, I'm just playing. listen to me on that occasion. He might have done, mate. Yeah, we'll come back to it in a second, though, because here's a chance for Charles. Into middle, Gonzalez there. Green's there. He gets the equaliser. Had a bar post on the volley. Completely won from Pitt. And out of nothing, on 16 minutes, it's all sort of 5-1, 12-1. That's...
The equalising goal for Charleston on 16, number 10, Kieran Culhaney.
Well, I've had two goals, it's unfair to spread things around. So we'll hand over to the one and only, Mr. Wishcraft. He'll take 3-3 out.
Thank you.
Come on, Dominic, I'm sucking.
Hands up!
2-1 to Hyde United on 23 minutes. The scorer, number 9, Dominic Murray.
Back to what is it?
Yeah.
it's going to be 8 days we're getting delivered towards the back post, towards the corner, whatever way Luke Clark's going to bring us away now. That's all the time, he's going to get in the rear ahead of him. Scores, go for this, Morata, can you give it back some back? Oh! Does really well, that's a take on Caddy. He's across the arms, and he just... Soft one again there, putting up his quick designs and momentum took him over there, which is a hell of a touch from Carl Dick for it there.
Today's attendance 678. 678, thank you very much for your support. Winning 50-50 draw ticket number 07953. 07953. £102 prize. Claim it in the press box at the back of the main stand. 07953.
Steps and guys are staring at him, a bit of space, deploy the shot.
He's a left foot, but he can play with right foot, so he's a
left foot. Get up there, man. What Saron Bale was challenging with Colleen, and just crazy hooks over his head, and he has to make a challenge with Luke David. Edison Davis came together, so we get to Luke David. Capone is almost defending on his own, and he's the only one kind of defending for Charles, isn't he?
Just to watch that right inside.
What's going to happen now? He's found him.
I told you.
I like how Cardiff picked it up. The way it was on Burke's left foot, just did sit up quite right from Burke.
Yeah. He only went south on that swing, like, it's a shaky body, it's just a natural position. He's never really had the power on it. Life and target.
It's going to come in and it's fine.
Six managers all going in. You probably had the same job, then. Keep the seat warm.
Thank you.
in the country can't pass in the middle. We have to keep saying
something that
there'll be a minimum of one added minute.
Wins ahead of against Burke, and it's going to shoot Gonzalez just wide in the end there. Davis from all across, and Gonzalez drills it wide in the end there. It's not rocket science. That's where Carl Jones comes in though, Berkey, for me. I'd have started with Carl Jones today, maybe, you know, just because it gives you that more offensive discipline.
Where he's sort of Elliot Rocket.
Yeah.
Elliot
Rocket's door. No, I know, but before we started, I would have had him in. I'm just trying to get around all of you and give you.
Don't worry about us, don't worry. He's come all the way from London.
Oh, that's a good one. It's over that cat.
I didn't have the sun in that shot, I'm more into me.
It's a long ball.
Well, I did say.
We're at a half-time substitution for Droylston. Number 17, Sean Holden. There's been a bit of a mistake on the team sheet, but if you've got a team sheet, Holden is number 17. So number 17, Sean Holden, replaces number 3, Ben Barber. Just a reminder, the winning 50-50 draw ticket not being claimed, 07953.
Shot comes in, oh, decent effort, but just going wide on the shot. And Anyway, free kick in time, bang on halfway. It's Paddy Miller to take it, captain. He's got 5 plays to aim, chief amongst them being Tyrone Gay there. It is drifted towards him, so on the edge of the penalty area, he reaches for it, can't quite get to it, on 25 yards out to Camsell. Ooh, he's tried to slide it in for Rocker, couldn't quite find him, mind you. And Killini, not as ginger as he used to be, but fair account nowadays. Maybe that's a problem on this new site. I can't stop them. The checks as well, as far as I am. Clearly, for a free kick, nothing, you know. The ball hasn't actually gone out. I think he's not ready up about it. We're up to three kickers next to him. But there you are.
He's not the only one.
That saves cancer chasing back. Like in that right wing position. Here's Jimmy Burke, puts him between two.
Ooh!
Gets a knee right in the face there. He's not that forward. So they work out his face. It was injured. He did stop with his noggin. He got away with one a little bit there.
Chris said he's got a bad knee. Yeah, you could hear it, couldn't you?
His head thundered into the knee of, I think it was Dylan Smith, who'd come across there, and he's got up for telling and he's going, oh, come on, eh? Not a couple of quarts away. Anyway, here's Crook with a free kick for the Tigers. Deep inside his own half. Gets plenty of distance on it, Martin. It's out from there. Daly's after this one for draws and gets an extended right boot onto it. He's got Marifa company as well. Gives it to Clark, though, who just plays it back and needs work this from the Bloods to get it out. And that's very, very, very good play indeed. Arlene now out to the left flank where Holden's waiting for it. Takes it down on the instep of his left boot. Gives it back to Arlene, who's got a bit of space to work with. Only Don Marie in front of him. He comes forward and goes around the on-rushing Ross Daly, who's not going to give him any change whatsoever there, and he's been forced backwards. He's kept the ball well, actually, Arlie, hasn't he? But he could have released it a lot sooner. Then. It's ludicrous, isn't it? Nice in across the wrong goal. He was never offside. Right, offside flag gone up there against Don Marie. There were two Ralston players playing him off. I was looking at that. It's ludicrous. Anyway.
You see any youngsters around with collecting buckets? There are only 12 fundraisers. So if you've got a chance, stick 50p in the bucket for them. You'll be able to tell them they're wearing club track suits and obviously carrying collecting buckets.
All right. You need the correcting dust.
You
know, yeah, come on.
So open your mouth, please. French brewery in the UK, you can tell it's more like permutations.
Yes, sir, it will. Well, permutations are that if I win 5 and draw 2 of the next 7 games that we've got left, then they will be promoted regardless. Because of the points per game ratio, Greenwich Borough, they can get 100 points over 46 games, that equates to 2.17 points, I think. If I get 92 points, they'll finish on 2.19 points per game, which will secure their promotion. They're playing Cray Wanderers today, John, between the fourth place. Well, we could have done with Cray winning our whole conversation as well. But
it's still going,
I know it's still going, but I'm just saying what we'd like to see. We're not up against Scarborough now, basically. We're up against Greenwich Borough. So ignore what Scarborough did. It doesn't matter at all. We're up against Greenwich Borough. Right, whoever's top of that basket league first division title. Just so you know. There you are. But we are by the way. Very rare. Very, very rare. Yeah, but when your team could get promoted on the technicality, AJ Cup and all that.
I'm going to tell you right now.
Well, I'd be very happy if you were right. I'd be deliriously happy if you were.
I'm not
happy
if you were.
But the thing is, you always shoot the ball and then get one. It's terrible stuff. Anyway, you're not missing any action. Anything that's gone in the second half, it remains 2-1 for the Tigers, both coming first to Hardy with Elliot Rock and Dominic Galina. Dominic Galina sandwiched between the two of them there on 16 minutes with the opponents of all of it. And it's taking a little bit of a back seat, the game, in the morning. It's not as exciting as the first half. Both teams going a little bit more direct than they were in the first period, whatever there by Clark, who somehow rolls above Pollock. Pollock's not at all, but I can assure you that Clark is the smartest. Great work by Hansel there. He's been tugged and pulled by Smith there, and eventually does win a free kick at the third or fourth time of asking. I don't think it should be a booking here, but the referee wants a word to stop it. Although they're putting him away, he's going away with his tail between his legs. Free kick then to the target, to be taken by Lipka out on the far side, probably about 30 yards up from the corner, but it's maybe 35 as his chant goes up from the shed. Flag to aim out in the middle here, goes towards the head of Marie, but couldn't quite get on to the end of it. It's up to a Porritt now, nods it back towards Camsell. We couldn't quite control it, and there's a little race on here now between Camsell. He's going to pick up the yellow card there for that foul. He's holding. Holding's furious about that, and he's a scavenger now. A bit of a
scavenger.
He's
never getting
there's no reason to dive in there. A bit of a foolish
Fitz Gonzalez and Kevin Ewan into the defuse situation straight away. Top more of a mischief and conflict in the first team.
Yeah, absolutely no question about that. Well, I say, so what do you say?
That's it!
The reaction there from Holden was gives it to his keeper Brannigan, who's just the 40 yards from there.
I think it's a role reversal now, does it? So that he kind of happened to hit Clausen on the break, and they say, right, what can you got Clausen on the hit you on the break? And then hit them last 20, they know if they fit the draw, and no draw from the right side. So they probably try and pick up with something, hit them with a solid at the end.
But
what do
you know about that? Well, he's been.
What did you just try and see?
Anyway, up with Donnery into the centre circle now, charging back now, under a bit of pressure here is Brannigan.
I've got all Charles and I, this time. Let's pass it out, there's loads of bodies round
here. In fairness, there was a completely and utterly missed clearance, really, yeah. On an air bar. 12 and a half minutes gone in this second, 2 months of the time. Yeah, so if you want to send us a tweet, by you can do, you're more than welcome. We're on 26 and all that. Go and send us an email at 26.gmail.com. If you want to send us a letter, send it to the press box, Newman Fields, and they'll probably get to us this time next year. It's Brownham on the far side working with the ball. Get it back to Lipka. Cancel now. Does a little bit of wet on the ball, but eventually loses out. Try to get himself out of a tricky situation that he played into the first one. Will to be there. Gay slips his boot in the close out on the far side.
It used to be a winger, but it's the same guy as him. It used to be a winger.
Oh, Jackie just inside his own arm there. He must. was saying this off air earlier on, but he must have been fouled more times than any other player in the league. It's absolutely ridiculous. And more players picked up bookings for fouling him than any other player in the league. It must be horrible to play against. I mean, I've never played that game on the yeah, absolutely, yeah. When you're a proper team. What's it like, though?
I was a ringer.
Ball given away just on the edge of the box there by Giralson, and falls here to Rocker. Tries to take it around his marker there, Capone, but can't quite manage to do so. Gets a cross through and it's gone out for a throw-in just about.
Great pressure. We just said he'll give it to him. He did. He passed it straight across the ball without looking straight at Yanni Lipkin. And he got thrown deep in the ball now. I think Matt Lynch will come on short as well.
Presumably for fake, but we'll update on that in a moment. Here's Bull. Plays it back to Daly. Far too much on that. And he goes out for a goal kick to the blood. 15 minutes gone in this first. Young young to the man with the most soothing voice, not just in non-league but in speed skating as well. It's the one and only with his Wick Academy hat on. It's true.
Substitution for Trailsden, number 12, Dominic Smith, replaces number 8, Callum Bagshaw. Substitution for Hyde United, number 14, Max Lennon, replaces number 10, Vic Campbell.
Just to clarify, we're sponsoring them, to be careful. It's
alright,
it is Lennon. I thought we'd test this without obviously Lennon, without doing a disturbance. I've got a big skill, but we're trying to be in that number 10 scheme or all, isn't it?
Yeah.
And Bailey's got his machine, he's not a bit too. Marina's got himself somewhere.
Substitution for Hyde United, number 17 Carl Jones replaces number 7 Elliot Rocker.
I don't know. Charged on. You know, the ball, 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 the
Alex Smith up against it. He finds a Luke Davey now. He's got Sean Morgan on the run and offense. And then Steve Smith looks around the car. Now he's a
I'm not too sure. I mean, three centre halves, two wing backs, and basically something that didn't do that.
Yeah.
Which, well, is a problem.
Yeah. We're just trying to decide who's going. It's going to be horrible.
Final Hyde United substitution, number 12, Harry Coates, replaces number 9, Dominic Murray.
Smith tearing down now, he lays out left to Ross Daly, he pops up on the left and lays it off now to Browner, good for sit, looking for Jones, headed away though.
Ooh.
And
now
Smith misses his kick, comes out to Ross Daly, Leonard on the end of the area, into Lipka, Leonard again, just took too long, and gives the ball away, and throws the ball up to Gonzalez, tries to lay the ball off, plays the ball in London, and the ball is flipped in again by Gonzalez, and Leonard plays the ball away again, and then Browner. And Morali with a scuff to the ball out left now to Sean Hill. He's back now to Ali again. So James Burke stayed right back, but Harry Coates is going to move an extra set now. Right. Yeah. 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 Is Ali though? He covers the up again. Plays it out to Clark. And Brannigan virtually is full centre half here for Charles.
The substitution for Droylston, number 16 Levi Phillips replaces number 5 Muhammad Ali.
Dylan Smithy has come in as a third centre half there for Droylston. Virtually playing two at the back, Droylston. And got four up top to Brown, and got five at the back. Now Jones, Dylan Smithy, Brown all up against the Jimmy, not Ian. Yeah, he's just coming back to fitness school, been out to work with the house, and I can see that.
I'm good.
Yeah. Dropping up towards Tyrone Gates, head out on the forest valley. 2.5 minutes to go. Massive moment after being a season, that was a save by Pierce Brosnan. for a kid, one important save that is, he's had an empty to do for it, but he was alert, wasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. I've held him down to three of them, to be honest. I've put him rushing out on me, so he did everything right with his textbook 101 save.
There'll be a minimum of 3 added minutes. 3 added minutes.
Twitter off as soon as the whistle's over, so we have it.
And,